Okay, students, our today's lecture is about ecology. Moving forward in this chapter, we will first understand the definition of ecology, which is the study of interactions among organisms and between organism and the physical and chemical factors making up their external environment. So this definition refers that the organism not only interact with other organisms, but also with the physical and chemical environment in which it lives. So this environment can be living or non-living. The physical environment or the non-living environment is called as abiotic factors, and the living factors are called as biotic factors. First, we will understand how non-living part of the environment interacts with the organisms. Physical environment includes amount of light. It includes water, temperature, salinity or pH of the soil or water, and the amount of oxygen present in the environment. Light, you all know that it is very important for all the living organisms, so it be animals or plants. You know that plants are directly dependent upon light because they have to carry out photosynthesis, and we animals are directly and indirectly dependent upon light as well. Amount of water, again, it's very important for both plants and animals to have water around them. Xerophytes are the plants which can live in conditions of prolonged drought in their habitat, that they can live in deficiency of water. Example of these kind of plants are cactus. If you have observed in common observation, it's a common observation that cactus can survive in limited amount of water because they can store water in their thick fleshy stems. Then there are plants which are partially or completely submerged in water. These plants are called hydrophytes. Then are nematophores. These arise from root system and project above the surface. The diagrams and the explanation of these three kind of plants are given in your textbook. Then is temperature. You all know that temperature is very important to be regulated for both plants and animals, since all the metabolic activities are enzyme catalyzed, and temperature has a great effect on enzyme activity. Next is pH of soil or water, that is salinity. So if you remember your chapter of osmosis and diffusion, we know that water moves from the area of higher concentration or higher water potential to the area of lower water potential. So if you will increase the pH or the alkalinity or acidity of any place, the water potential will always be disturbed, and which will lead to the water movement in or out of the cells. We will go through its explanation by the help of diagrams in our next lesson. Next is amount of oxygen present. Amount of oxygen, you all know that aerobic respiration is a very important reaction happening in all plants and animals. In absence of oxygen, plants are unable to respire, so do the animals.